the story of how Halloween began. And it isn't what you'd think. Once upon a time, in a town named Halloween, before the tales of goblins or ghosts, there were three ferocious robbers. At night, they hid by the side of the road. The first one had a blunderbuss. The second one had a bellows filled with pepper. The third one had a huge red axe. If you think today's Halloween is scary, these robbers used to make every woman faint with fear, and even the bravest of men scurry off like mice. This is the spooky tale of the robbers we now call Trick or Treaters.
We are dressed in black and big black hats, creeping through the night. Gold and silver jewels we rob, so don't put up a fight. The moon alone, he laughs with us when our blunderbuss ignites. Take heed and hand it over, or you'll feel our might. We only want what's in your bag, we promise we won't bite. The gun will draw, the axe will fall, if this does not go right. But we will say we do enjoy giving you a fright. Silently we creep along, your fear is our delight. Ba-boom, ba-boom, gold in your bags, but we don't mind the load. If you leave at night, you should take another road. Ba-boom, ba-boom, it's time, put your hands up and surrender. Even little owls know to watch out for our temper. The towns around are full of clowns that promise you protection. You don't see how fast they run when we're in their direction. They hear us and hear us, we make our way. Our boots can break through bricks. The fatter the pockets, the fatter the belly. They sound like squealing pigs. Ba-boom, ba-boom, it's yours to have, so please be on your way. We'll load the treasure in the crates, please no more pepper spray. We don't care where you go, just hope you spare our lives. We know to stay out of your way, three robbers own the night.
Please!
Far away from our three robbers was a young orphan named Tiffany. Her life was full of more tricks than treats. But that would all change. She just didn't know it yet.
Mom and Dad, I've come here to say goodbye. I miss you so much. I wish we were all back home together again. The coach is going to take me away soon.
We're leaving.
Say goodbye, Tiffany. The coach is waiting.
All right, all right.
Of course, stamp and sign. She is now property of the orphanage. Isn't that right, Tiffany?
I'm not going to the orphanage. I don't wanna. Penelope and I don't wanna go.
Enough. Yeah.
Let me out of here. We don't wanna go. Hello?
Goodbye, little Tiffany. Take care. It's not easy being a policeman. And those darn robbers are also still on the loose for 30 years now. Man, oh man. What a brave girl. off she goes to the orphanage.
It's locked.
Well, I guess we're safe. Nobody's gonna get in here, Penelope. But if you're afraid, you could come sit over here next to me. I can put my arm around you if it makes you feel better. See, that's better, right? It was just an owl, silly. Penelope, you need to be brave. Don't be afraid. I'll look after you and keep you safe.
Meanwhile, deep in the woods, the three robbers in our story are on the prowl, waiting for the next coach to come by.
Maximus,
Felix,
Dominique,
gold, gold, we want your gold. Gold, gold, we want your gold. Gold, gold.
Well now, have a seat, Miss Penelope. I'll read you a fairy tale. Once upon a time, there was a Maharaja. Woo! Maharaja. And he lived in a golden palace full of gold. So he lived in this palace right in the middle of India. And it was filled with jewels. Oh, yes, it was. But the best part was the treasure chamber. It was really amazing. It was jam-packed with real pearls and emeralds, diamonds, gold, silver, rings, necklaces, crowns, bracelets, and shawls. But his greatest treasure lived in the children's room, for it was his daughter. She was very beautiful and so brave. Braver than anyone in the whole world. The Maharaja loved his daughter so much that he granted her every wish. One day, the Maharaja gave his beautiful daughter an orphanage. It was by far the nicest orphanage in all of India. The cheers were enormous. And so, all of a sudden,
what is it?
Yes, what is it, Maximus?
Nothing inside. Just a little girl.
A girl?
Good evening. Hey, watch it.
Take care of the driver.
Boom. Oh, look! A little suitcase.
What are you doing? Leave my stuff alone, you mean old robber!
nothing.
Same here.
Nada.
Darn it! What are they doing, Penelope?
Nothing. No gold. Darn it!
You buffoon! Put the darn safety on, Dominic.
Relax, Maximus.
Felix, come on. There's nothing here. Let's go. How bad can this get? Three of the world's best robbers, and the only coach all week has nothing in there but a little girl.
What did we do to deserve this? Let's get some schnitzel.
Thieves, stop! You can't just leave me alone here.
We're not thieves. We're robbers.
Robbers!
I said stop! Hey, take me with you! I am your loot, after all.
That was a good one.
Well, then, I guess you stay penniless. Okay, well, Miss Penelope, it seems these robbers have enough gold!
Gold?
La, 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 la.
Gold? Did you just say gold?
There wasn't any gold in there, just a kid and her doll.
Children don't have any gold.
But it just so happens that my daddy's a rich Maharaja. He has so much gold that,
You're lying! No.
You can take me with you and trade me for my daddy's gold. Then everybody's happy, and you'll be rich.
What do you guys think? I mean, these are tough times.
Yeah, tough times.
It wasn't so bad working a day job.
I'm not going back to telemarketing.
Now listen carefully, little girl. You're our prisoner now.
There is no escape.
Resistance is futile.
Yes!
Let's move it!
And so the three robbers went off with Tiffany. Little did they know that this young girl would change so much for them and for us all.
Work's over, brothers. Just throw the rascal in a corner.
But she's sleeping so peacefully. Shouldn't we,
In our bed? How about over my dead body?
That was the first night, and they all slept peacefully.
I'm in big trouble. Oh, she's never going to believe me. I should just run away. No, no, no. Where would I go?
Me too.
Shh, she's
children. My sweet little orphans.
Who I love so much.
I am very troubled.
You have deeply...
Hey, Gregory, we're late. Annie's upset again. We gotta go. Everybody's already up. Like, wake up. Come on.
Gregory, are you listening? She says we broke her heart. Do you know what she'll do to us?
Get up!
Why don't you just tell Auntie I'm sick? It's too early in the morning for this, Nicholas. Oh, how rude.
What is...
Nicole rude? You!
No, beats no love, Auntie.
I can't hear you, boy.
No beats no love, Auntie.
That's correct.
Now repeat.
No beats no love, Miss Auntie.
Simple, isn't it? Or at least it should be.
How many sugar beets do you see? Is that all I mean to you children? Not a smidgen more? How then can I possibly love you? My dear little children!
Good morning, Auntie.
Oh, had the two little princes decided to grace us with their presence?
I trust you are well rested. It's about time. Where has he been? And where is the girl?
Robbers, madam. Dozens of them. I tried to save her, but I couldn't. There were just too many. I fought like a lion, but they took her anyway. But I did save the coach, and I'm here now.
He failed to bring the child back to me.
What?
What a tragedy. He knows the consequences of disappointing me so deeply.
You silly fool! Today, all you orphans are going to show me how much you love me. My children, I want to see lots and lots of beets!
No beets! No love! Go! Wait! You two stop! Now then, it's just us three dear little princes. Get to the machine! No beats, no love, no beats, no love, no beats.
Oh, no! What are you going to do now?
I'd really like to know what this machine really does.
Meanwhile, our robbers were fast asleep, dreaming of ways to be even scarier. But remember, children, Halloween, as we know it, couldn't have happened without the little girl, Tiffany, who added a little something sweet to the day we now love.
Ooh.
La, 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 la.
Pesky bats. I'm not scared of you.
Good morning, spider.
La-di-da-da-da, la-di-da-da-da, la-di-da-da. La-di-da-da-da. La 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 la.
Hmm. that? Those poor children. That must be the orphanage. They're working so hard. Oh, Penelope, I'm so glad we didn't end up there.
These days, you might be scared of haunted houses, but this was the real deal. And even though the robbers tried so hard to be spooky, they were no match for the evil auntie.
It wasn't made clear to you.
Do you have any idea how concerned I am about this poor little girl?
I assure you, my... But, madam!
Talk. I want that snotty little girl here by tomorrow. Do you understand me? Do you understand?
Yes, ma'am. Should be there in the morning.
I will make you regret this, and it's the last thing I do!
Yes, ma'am! Double time!
All right. So I'll have labeled wanted posters with Tiffany's pictures printed right away. Oh, I hope that the print shop is open this early. Hello?
Hello? The coffee smells so good. I applaud you, Miss Penelope. Colors! Pretty! Yellow, yellow, yellow! Yellow, yellow, yellow.
Green, 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 green.
Orange, 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 orange.
Red, 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 red.
Pink, pink, pink.
Blue, 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 blue.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It all smells so good.
Enough! I'm tired of this. How do we get our gold, little girl?
It's actually pretty easy. A letter.
What?
We need a letter. So, my daddy knows that you got me.
A letter?
From us?
So he can send you the gold. When you have it, you can set me free.
Sounds good. Really, so smart.
The problem is...
What's the problem?
My daddy lives far away. So very far away. So we must wait a little for the gold to arrive.
What do you mean, a while?
Two? Maybe three?
Seconds?
Minutes?
Hours?
Weeks?
That long?
And where is your... daddy?
In India.
In India?
Where's in India, you bobblehead?
Well, isn't that great?
Can't I think in peace in my own home for once?
What's wrong, Maximus?
I'm trying to figure out how on earth we are going to get our gold.
With a letter, like I said.
Exactly.
With a letter.
Quiet! You motor mouths! The problem is...
What's the problem?
He doesn't know how to write.
I can't write either.
I know how to write.
It's only 2 weeks, Maximus. She won't bother anybody.
And she can make coffee.
Miss Penelope did that.
That was cute, wasn't it?
Boys, I request ink and paper.
Again!
Taking care of this machine is the worst.
Yeah, and the mashed beets really stink.
Blech. Yuck.
Hey, Gregory, taste this. It's really amazing.
Fantastic.
What do you suppose it is?
I think it's from the beet machine, and it's really awesome. It's really awesome.
It's like beet syrup, and I just can't stop.
Why don't we get any instead of that smelly porridge?
He's not allowed to have sugar. Unhealthy, bad for teeth, makes them sick. Wait till Auntie finds out.
Right, dear Maharaja.
No, dear won't do. This is no normal letter. Keep thinking.
Well, I'm a robber and not a writer. Okay. Honorable Maharaja.
No, too polite.
No.
I'll just write Maharaja.
Wow, you draw very neat letters.
Right, Maharaja. We've taken your daughter who... No. Let's see. We've robbed your daughter, taken... No, of course. We've robbed... No, taken your daughter... No, robbed. Etc. and so forth. And no police. Understood?
We have taken... What was that again?
Maharaja? No. Maharaja, we've taken your daughter. No. Your daughter was robbed. No. No, of course. Taken. No. We've robbed... No. Taken your daughter... taken... No. Right, taken, et cetera, and so forth. And don't call the police. Understood?
Police. Finished.
I'm sick of this place. I'm leaving, now!
What?
I'm running away, you too.
But Andy said we can't run away, Gregory. We're gonna end up like those three brothers that are stuck in the woods. They were taken by wolves, and when the moon is full, you can still hear them howl. It's really scary.
Are you serious? You believe that?
Of course I do.
Come on, let's get the sheets, quick, let's go.
You ready? I'm gonna go first.
No, you don't. It was my idea. I'm going first.
Ah, so cute! An escape attempt!
Come on, Nicholas, let's go!
You're much too weak to be living outside these walls. They'll be back.
Tiffany, where'd you learn to write like that?
My mommy showed me how.
I wish I could write too. That'd be great.
I can show you how.
Me? With these sausage fingers?
Sure.
That wouldn't be too bad. I mean, knowing how to write. I could write my memories.
Dominic, it's memoirs.
Da do da 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 do. Hey, there it is! The Forest Mailbox! Express delivery!
And someone will find it?
Why, sure, everybody comes this way. Everyone!
sugar machine. Oh, I can't wait to eat something fancy.
Maybe a buttercream pie?
No. Peppermint candies? No. Oh, no! A candy cane! I love candy canes! I love, 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 love them!
I can't wait to make a million candy canes just for me.
Oh, my candy cane! I can't wait. Oh, here we go. My sugar machine is so perfect! Okay, one, two, three, four!
Auntie forced the children to find beets to make her candy. See, back then, little kids didn't get any sweets, no matter how scary things might have been. Don't worry, children. That will change. How, you ask? Oh, you'll just have to wait and see.
My little candy cane! Oh, why, it's so good! It's lovely!
What's that?
It's a layer cake of many flavors!
Oh, I can't wait to eat it.
So, the letter's on its way.
And in 2 weeks, we'll finally have our gold.
And then I'm finally free to leave at last. Yippee.
Isn't that wonderful? Then you get to go back to your home to be with your daddy. Ha in India.
Yes, that would be nice to be home again in my golden palace. With my three big brothers.
What?
You have brothers?
Three of them?
Yeah, they're the best big brothers. One plays hide and seek with me for as long as I want. When I'm tired of that, the other one shows me some new elephant tricks.
Sit!
And the third one even has a flying carpet.
And we fly!
Enough of this gibberish. We have to go to work.
Oh. All right, work.
Come on, brothers.
And we'll bring you a little something afterward, Tiffany. Ah, what a wonderful, just wonderful night.
Dominic.
Good luck and lots of treasure.
Tiffany.
Yes?
Make yourself comfortable.
Exactly. Feel right at home. A flying carpet.
I'm hungry. Did you hear that? What is it?
All I hear is your heart.
Hmm.
Got it? Got it?
Teddy bear, you're on your own. Teddy bear, run on home. Teddy bear, turn around. Teddy bear, not a sound. Teddy bear, how old are you? 105. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm an Indian princess!
Look at that.
She's a natural.
She'd make a great little robber.
You've got a lot of gold. What do you do with it all?
We hide it.
Why?
Why?
And once you've hidden it, what do you do with it then?
Let's see.
No idea.
I don't know why.
Well,
we just keep it.
In our treasure chamber. This is where we put it.
Mm-hmm.
We brought you something, Tiffany.
Yeah.
Just a little something.
We did.
But don't break it.
You guys are so sweet, but I can't even play the piano.
Let's hit it, brothers. To the instruments.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Me too. I want an instrument. Felix, pretty please.
Here, take this. Play it only 3 times.
See, Tiffany was teaching the robbers that it's important to have some fun. No one likes being scared all the time. Just ask our 2 little lost boys.
Well, at least it's better out here than at the orphanage. Right, Nicholas? Tomorrow we'll collect wood earlier to make a campfire for the night.
Right.
Ouch! Good night, Nicholas.
Good night, Gregory. Are those glowworms again?
That was the second night, and they all slept peacefully.
Mr. Woodpecker, that's it. I've warned you enough. Now I'm writing you up for disturbing the peace.
Charges filed against Mr. Woodpecker. Now, what's your address?
Good morning, students.
Good morning, Tiffany.
Good morning, Princess.
Today, we'll learn how to read and write.
Yippee!
Swell!
Let's start.
Here are all your ABCs. A.
A.
B.
Unbelievable.
Brilliant.
C.
That's okay. Hey, I can write.
Cab. Hey, I can read.
Great.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their creator with certain inalienable rights. Among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
Boys, you get straight A's.
Bum, 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 bum.
You might see magical creatures on your street on Halloween night, but back then, they were real. Or so the policeman says.
Write you up? You don't even exist. You're just a figment of my wild imagination.
Weird.
Gentlemen, what you're doing here clearly constitutes as indecent behavior, and you... Hey, stop! I hereby issue you a warning. Oh, my.
Look, isn't that the policeman?
He's so foolish. Robbing him would be easy.
He's probably writing up some sales for breaking the speed limit.
He's such a fool. Hello, Tiffany.
What? Incredible. I knew it all along.
Looks like Tiffany, doesn't it?
We know how to read now. So read it.
Tiffany. What? Tiffany!
Aha! A wanted poster.
Well then, maybe she has a twin sister.
Sure, and her name's Tiffany. She's playing us for a fool, the little liar.
It's a possibility. Wanted. Ooh. She's wanted. Tiffany's wanted, just like we are, you guys.
The little orphan Tiffany.
orphan?
A little orphan. So then that means she has no parents.
That would mean there's no Maharaja, no elephants, and no brothers.
And not a single ounce of gold.
So why did we send the letter?
On Halloween, we wear countless disguises. But Tiffany had the greatest disguise of all. She had truly wanted to be someone else.
Good evening, robbers.
Someone with a family.
What does this say,
It says, Wanted, the orphan Tiffany.
Pardon me?
Wanted, the little orphan Tiffany.
You thought you could just steal from us? Take advantage of us? Eat us out of house and home? You must think you're pretty smart.
I wanted to be a robber, too.
What fools you must think we are. We're only the lame brain robbers. We won't be pushed around by a little girl. You lied to us.
Maximus.
True. I am an orphan. And now I'm going to the orphanage. That's where orphans belong. There's no gold. I'm absolutely worthless.
Tiffany, you can't just leave.
Goodbye, Dominic. Thank you for letting me sleep in your bed.
Maximus, for goodness sakes, the child is leaving.
Maximus, Tiffany's going to the orphanage.
Finally, it's quiet. It's peaceful.
Great, this quiet. Quite a quiet, quiet.
Dominic?
What should we do?
Hey, Maximus. Poor little Tiffany is all alone in the forest. She forgot her Penelope, and we just let her go to the orphanage all alone.
Leave me alone. It's the middle of the night. She's just a little liar, huh?
You're right, Maximus. What do you care about orphans? I'm sure you remember that about yourself, right, Maximus?
No beets, no love.
No beets.
Enough of the orphans and the beets. We are not going.
Hey.
Yes, years ago, our three robbers had lived in that awful orphanage with the evil auntie. They had managed to escape, but would Tiffany and the others manage to do the same?
Glowworms, Nicholas. Glowworms. We're surrounded by tiny little glowworms. They're just so cute.
Hello there.
A girl? A normal little really cute girl?
Well, I think you're an orphan.
I guess you're right. How'd you know?
There were robbers, and a girl was stolen 3 nights ago from a coach. We're runaway orphans. We're all orphans.
My name's Gregory.
And I'm Nicholas. What's your name?
Tiffany.
That was the third night, and no one slept at all.
We're runaway orphans, off to see the world. The world is waiting for us. Would you like to join us in our quest?
The world doesn't interest me. I've seen it. Nobody's waiting for me.
That'll change. After a while, you just get used to it.
Hmm. Here, a present.
Oh, I can't believe it. Is it stolen?
Nonsense. I don't steal.
Unbelievable! We're rich! We can live off of that! We'll buy a house! No, better yet, a boat! We'll go cruising! Or a coach with sleeping compartments! Yeah, oh. Or we could have a coach and a boat!
Gold, gold, gold! Who cares about the darn gold? The robbers only took me because they wanted more gold!
Robbers?
They don't care if I'm an orphan. What do they know about being all alone?
Hey, where are you going?
I'm going to the orphanage.
Tiffany, you're crazy.
Children without parents belong in the orphanage, so there.
Wait, we have to stick together.
You can't be alone in the forest.
Take a good look. Do you really want to live there?
You'll be bossed around by the headmistress, the terrible auntie.
At least there are other orphans like us there.
Without that witch, living with the kids there wouldn't be so bad.
How many kids live there?
About 20 or 100.
No. At least 300, or maybe 765.
And one headmistress?
One.
Only one headmistress?
And she's very scary.
She lives up in the tower.
No one can guess what she does up there.
Come on then, let's go.
Oh, there she is. She's really going to the orphanage, Dominic.
Wow, and there are two others with her.
We have to go there, Maximus.
I can't, brothers. Not to the orphanage. To see the evil auntie. I just can't. I'm scared.
Together we can do it. It's for Tiffany. Right, Dominic?
Felix is right. We have to get going.
Let's go.
Quiet. We don't want to get caught.
Don't worry. The kids are asleep after working all day making beet juice.
But Auntie's always awake. Even at night, she sits up in her room. You can hear her making weird sounds. Nom 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 sounds.
Better watch out for the coachman.
Why?
He's always lurking in some dark corner.
And when you least expect it, he finds you.
Let's go to the headmistress's room. Follow me.
I think we'd rather stay outside.
We will keep watch.
Bye, chicken. See you soon.
Good luck.
You'll need it. Quack.
So, Tiffany climbed up to face the evil auntie. This was no haunted house or pretend ghost. This was real life. All of the children were counting on her. But could one little girl make a difference?
Oh, what a dainty little cupcake!
All we need is another cute little one!
What was that? Well, how about that? My sweet little princes, get ready for the mission!
This is impossible! Truly unbelievable. I must be dreaming.
Welcome, dear children, to the show entitled
titled The World's Most Foolish Boys by sweet Nicholas and adorable Gregory. You're so cute. Would you like to take part in this presentation?
Very nice. And are you foolish enough? We shall see. Yes.
Little orphans, it's going to be very amusing.
I'll sing, you'll dance. Here we go.
In the woods live the rumpers.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
In the forest. For breaking the speed limit, I hereby fine you $1,000.
Oh, so much for that.
I don't believe it.
Clever little Maximus and his two half-wit brothers. Little dope Dominic. And Felix the nincompoop.
Well, you runaways, my, how you've grown so well. It's been 30 years since I've seen you.
You brought your doll, Tiffany.
Miss Penelope, you forgot her and us too.
Aww.
And we wanted to ask if...
Yes?
If you want to come back to us, we miss you.
Oh.
It's so fun having you around. Your laugh and, you know, it... And, you know, it really tickles our robber's ears. Mm-hmm. What do you say? Please?
Aw. Maximus.
Remind you, not so fast. I have a say in all of this.
The Orphan Children Act clearly states that all children without parents belong in an orphanage where they'll squash beets until there's nothing left.
Blah.
Fine, you ungrateful swine. Maybe I'm the one that should be done with this place, right? Evil has no place with children. Pity. Okay. Ungrateful vermin. That's the last you're going to see of me. It's your own fault.
You see? As a last request, I want a Ripper float.
Ripper float, Ripper float, Ripper float.
I love
Ta-da! Ta-da!
Down there. Robbers' hats. Robbers' hats. Robbers' hats means robbers. Attention! Everyone listen! Robbers, please step forward.
There are no robbers, officer. Only orphans.
And that was the last anyone saw of the evil auntie. The orphans were free at last to play as much as their hearts desire. And that's why, on Halloween, children get to stay up past their bedtimes.
This place is ours now!
That is not correct! This place is now property of the government! From now on, I'm in charge! Yeah!
We'll buy it. Boys, let's show them.
That's it? Coin. I'm sorry, children. It's very nice of you, but it's not enough. You see, it's not nearly enough.
The robbers used their gold to buy the orphanage. And the anniversary of that wonderful day is what we now know as Halloween.
Whenever a child was left to cry, the robbers would take them in. And as they were raised, they honored the men by wearing their clothes in red. As love had grown within the home, the letter changed its shape. And all the children would look out and say,
"Hip, hip, hooray!"
For the three robbers, they no longer stole gold, but instead gave sweets to all the kids who asked for them. And that's why Halloween is filled with candy. It's important to remember that while sometimes you need to trick, it's just as important to have a treat. The robbers would forever be remembered as the first trick-or-treaters.